So here's a typical group of friends in middle school. And some of the people are popular, some of them might not be. The first step to deciding who's popular is looking at who has a lot of friends. So let's draw in some links that show who's a friend. And friendship links are one directional. Just because Alice is friends with Bob doesn't mean that Bob is friends with Alice. So we'll draw our links as arrows. So this means this person, we'll call him Bob, is friends with Alice. And let's say Alice has many friends. And let's say Bob is also friends with this person. They're friends with each other. We have lots of friendship links. Some of them are bidirectional, but not all of them. So we have lots of friendships. So is this enough to decide who's popular? So if you went to a school like I did, it's not. Just having a lot of friends is not enough to make you popular. You have to have the right friends. You have to be friends with the popular people. So it's not enough to have lots of geeky friends, say, in high school. You've got to have lots of friends that are popular. So that means that the definition of popular isn't just about having lots of friends. It's about having lots of friends who also have lots of friends. That's what makes someone popular. So we can define popularity of a person is the number of people who are friends with P. This means the number of links from someone else to that person is their popularity score. So here is Charlie. So there are one, two, three links into Charlie. So Charlie's popularity score would be 3. Alice also has 3 links, so her popularity score would also be 3. Bob only has one arrow going to Bob, so his popularity score would be 1. So this isn't a bad way to define popularity, but it's not quite right. So the definition of popularity doesn't just depend on the number of friends you have, it depends on both the number and the popularity of your friends. So we can change the definition. Let's instead define the popularity score of a person P. Now it's going to be the sum of the popularities of all of their friends. So we can write that in a mathematical way. So using the sigma means to sum up. We're going to take each friend that is in the friends of P, and we're going to sum up the popularity score of the friends. If the mathematical notation is unfamiliar to you, we could also write this as pseudo Python code. We're thinking of the popularity of a person P. Let's assume we have a function that gives us the friends. So we're going to start with the score as 0. We're going to loop through the friends. And for each friend, we're going to add to P's score the popularity score of the friend. And we'll return the score as the result. So now you've seen a mathematical definition of popularity. You've seen the same thing as code. I'm going to ask you a very important quiz question next. It's an easy one to get right if you try twice because there's only two answers. But think about it carefully. See if you can get it right the first time.